So, in this video, we plan to discuss on Warshall's algorithm. So, Warshall's algorithm will work with transitive closure with use of a directed graph. So, whenever we are having a graph which is directed, it will be taking a path from node A to node B. So, let's see this particular graph, the graph having four nodes. That are said to be A, B, C, D. So from A, we can able to travel to B. And apart from B, there is no paths to reach D and C. When you are taking B, there is a path to reach D, but we are not having any other path to reach A or C. When you are taking C, from C, we can able to reach nothing, because there is no path from C to reach node A or node B or node D. The same case from the node D, we are having two different paths that are said to be D to C and D to A. It's not possible to reach B from D. There is no direct path to reach B. So this is the graph what we are having. So from this graph, we have to identify the transitive closure. So how can we will identify the transitive closure? Let's see. So here we are making a table. And with use of the table, we are making the transitive closure. The table mentions the matrix we are making. With use of that matrix, we are identifying the transitive closure. So first we are taking for A. From A, how to reach A? So A to A, is there any path existing? There is no self loop, but there is a cycle. How we can reach A from A? We are starting from A and we are moving to B, and from B we are moving to D, from D we are moving to A. So this way we are reaching A again, so that there is a path exist for A to A, so that we are putting one here. Okay, in the particular matrix A to A, we are putting 1. Let's see A to B. A to B, what we are having? We are having 1. How we are putting 1 here? There is a path from A to B. There is a directed graph from A to B, so that we are putting 1 here. A to C, what we are having? When we are having A to C, there is a path exist. How the path exist? A to B, B to D, D to C. A to B, B to D, D to C. So in this way, we can able to reach C. So this way we can able to reach the node C from node A. When you are taking D, how we can reach D from node A? We can able to go to B. From B, we can able to go to D. Okay. So there also, there is a path exist from A to D. So the first row, all you are seeing 1, that's from A, you can able to reach all the nodes. Okay, all the 4 nodes you can able to reach. From A to B, you can able to reach. A to A, you can reach via A to B, B to D, D to A. And A to C, you can reach via A to B, B to D, D to C. Then A to D, you can reach via A to B and B to D. Okay, let's see the second row. Second row will be with the node B. With the node B, we can able to reach all the nodes. How we can able to reach all the nodes? Let's start with B. When you are starting from B, is it possible to reach B again? Mean by there is a self loop. Yes, we can able to go to D, B to D, D to A, A to B. So we can able to reach B again when you are starting from B. So that is said to be a self loop. So B to B, it's 1. So B to A, is it possible? So B to D, then D to A. So this way we can able to reach A. So from B, we can able to reach D. From D, we can reach able to reach A. That is a path exists, so that B to A, that is a connection. Okay. Then what is the next one? B to D, B to C. So B to C, we can able to reach via B to D and D to C. Okay. B to D and D to C. So B to A we've seen, B to B there is a path, B to C there is a path, B to D, we are having direct path. So B to D, we are having direct path so that we can put 1. So for the second row, we are getting all 4 ones. And when you are seeing the third node, when we are taking from C, there is no cycle starting from C. There is no cycle we are having from C. So that 0. So C to A, there is no path. C to B, there is no path. C to C also, there is no path. C to D also, there is no path. So all 4 values are 0. So C to A is 0, C to B is 0, C to D, C is 0, C to D is also 0. When we are taking the node D, when you are taking D to D, it's possible. How it's possible? D to A, A to B, B to D. So in this case, we have a cycle here. So reaching D is possible, so that we are putting 1 for D to D. Let's see for D to A. D to A, there is a path exist. The same way, D to B, D to A, then A to B, we are having a path. Same case, D to C, we are having a path. So we are having path to A, B, C, and D also. So all 4 categories, we are having the path, so that we are putting 1. So this is our transitive closure matrix, what we are identifying from the given graph. So for this particular transitive closure matrix, we have to draw the graph. So how we can draw the graph? When you are taking node A, A to A, there is self loop. A to B, there is a path. Then A to C also, there is a path. A to D also, there is a path. Okay. Then we are taking node B. B to B also, there is a self loop. B to A also, there is a path. B to C also, there is a path. B to D also, there is a path. From C, there is no path to any nodes. When you are taking D to A, there is a path. D to B, there is a path. D to C, there is a path. And D to D also, there is a path. So when you are seeing the final graph, the graph will become like this. This is the graph for the transitive closure. As I told, from A, we can able to reach A, then B, then C, then D. So all nodes, we have the connectivity. When you are taking B, from B, we have a self loop. B to A is possible. B to B is also possible. B to C is possible. And B to D also possible. When you are taking C, there is no path from C. So that there is no out vertex, out edge from C. Only in nodes we are having for C. Then when you are taking D, from D, we can able to reach A. We can able to reach B. We can able to reach C. And we can able to reach D. That is a self loop. Okay. So this is our final solution graph for the given problem. So whatever problem we are getting, we have to identify the transitive closure matrix. From the transitive closure matrix, we have to identify the final graph. Okay. This is said to be Warshall's algorithm. So thank you. Thank you very much.